Hey everyone, how's it going on? Welcome to Analytics School. This is session 28 in SAS programming series. Proc Freq is one of the most frequently used SAS procedures which help us to summarize categorical variables. It calculates counts, frequencies and cumulative frequencies of categories of our categorical variables. In addition to that, it returns the number of the percentages of cases falling in multiple categories of our categorical variables. Apart from that, it can also produce bar charts and test for association between two categorical variables such as chi-square test. So let's go ahead and see the practical applications of Proc Freq. One of the dataset which we are going to use in Proc Freq is cars dataset, and one can access the cars dataset from SAS Help library. And here we are creating a temporary dataset called cars using the data step. Let's run the Proc content statement and see what are variable types. So here you can see the cylinder is a numerical variable type, drivetrain is categorical, engine size is numerical, and so on. And here you can see make, model, origin, and type, they are again categorical variables. As I've already mentioned, that Proc Freq is basically used to analyze the categorical data, whereas Proc univariate or Proc means they are basically used to analyze the numerical variables. So let's go ahead and do few examples to understand Proc Freq in better way. One can see the distribution of the data by using Proc Freq statement, and this is the most naive form of using Proc Freq statement. By mentioning Proc Freq, then data equal to and whatever the data set it is you are using, in our case it is cars, and then colon, semicolons, and then using run statement. Now the Freq procedure is a descriptive procedure as well as a statistical procedure. It produces one way as well as an wave frequency tables, and it can concisely describe your data by reporting the distribution of variable values. You can use the Freq procedure to create cross tabulation tables that summarize the data for two or more categorical variables by showing the number of observations for each combination of variable values. And I would like to mention here that do not use this naive form, because if you have lot of variables which and let's say you have numerical variable also as well as categorical variables, then it does not make sense to run this particular statement, and it is going to give you an output which is not appropriate. And I'm going to show you the preferred way how to use the Proc Freq statement, but just for the sake of it, what output it is going to give it to you, I'm just running this particular code. So here you can see it is giving you an output for each and every variable. Make, which is a categorical variable. Model, again a categorical variable. And if we will go down, you can see here it is giving you a distribution of MSRP and invoice and all the other numerical variables. But if you have noticed here, in the beginning, it is giving you the distribution of the categorical variables like make, model, then type, origin, and drivetrain. So these are all the categorical variables, and Proc Freq has automatically taken into the consideration that these are the categorical variables and these are the preferred variable types for which a person is going to see the frequency table. And then it is giving an output for the numerical variables. So this is the most naive form of using Proc Freq. Let's say if you want to see the distribution of a particular variable, then one has to use a table statement with Proc Freq. And this is the general format of using a table statement. So Proc Freq data equal to the data set which is cars, then table statement, the variable which we are using here origin, because we want to see the distribution of origin. If you want to see for drivetrain or for type or make or model, whatever you want to use. So in our case, we are using origin here, and let's run the code and see what output it is going to give us. So here you can see it is showing us the distribution of variable origin, and these are the attributes of origin: Asia, Europe, and USA. You can see the frequency. What is the percentage in the whole data set? The cumulative frequency and the cumulative percentage. This is how one can use tables in the Proc Freq procedure and get an output for a single variable. Let's say if you want to see the distribution of multiple categorical variables in one go, then you can mention multiple variables in the table statement. So this is the code, and here I have mentioned make, origin and drivetrain, and I want to see the distribution of these three categorical variables. Let's run the code and see how the data looks like into the result data set. So you can see here, it is giving me the distribution of the make variables, and these are the attributes like Audi, BMW, Cadillac, Chevrolet, and this is for the origin variable, Asia, Europe and USA, giving the frequency table, as well as the percentage, cumulative frequency and cumulative percentage. And then drivetrain is here, all front and rear, and these are the frequency table. So this is the way one can mention multiple variables in the table statement and see the frequency distribution of multiple variables in one go. So far, we have used the Freq procedure to create one-way frequency tables. However, it is often helpful to cross-tabulate frequencies of two or more variables. The simplest cross-tabulation is a two-way table. To create a two-way table, join two variables with an asterisk in the table statement of a Proc Freq step. So this is the general format which you are going to use to create a n-way frequency table. So this is a two-way frequency table. Here I have put up an asterisk between origin and drivetrain. So it is going to give you an output between origin and drivetrain, where the attributes of origin will be an index, whereas drivetrain attributes will be columns. So as you can see here, origin attribute Asia, Europe, USA, and then total is here, and these are the attributes of drivetrain, all front and rear, and then total. So drivetrain attributes have become columns, and here you can see origin attributes are index. So this is the general output you are going to get. Now how we are going to read this particular output? So the first thing which you will see here, 34, 99, 25, 36, 37, 50, these are the frequencies of Asia and all, Asia and front, and Asia and rear. So in Asia, all type is, which is all wheel drive type is 34, Asia and front wheel drive is 99, and Asia and rear wheel drive is 25. Similarly for Europe, it is 36 for all wheel drive, Europe and front wheel drive is like 37, and for rear wheel drive is 50, and total frequency is 123. Then you will get the cell percentage of total frequency. So if you will divide 34 by 428, it is 7.94%. 99 divided by 428 is 23.13%, and 25 divided by 428 is 5.84%, and so on. You can calculate it for Europe and USA. Then the third row which you are seeing here is the cell percentage of row frequency, and this is calculated by 34 divided by 158, you will get 21.52, 99 divided by 158, 62.66, and 25 divided by 158, which is 15.82, and you can calculate for Europe and USA. And the last row which you are seeing here, 36.96, 43.81, and 22.73, is the cell percentage of column frequency. So 34 divided by 92, you will get 36.96. Then if you will divide 99 by 226, you will get 43.81. And similarly, 25 divided by 110, you will get 22.73. And this is how you are going to read your 2x2 frequency distribution. In this session, I have mentioned many times that if one needs to analyze the numerical variables, one should use proc means or proc univariate procedure. But let's say if you want to see the distribution of a numerical variable with a numerical variable, or numerical variable with a categorical variable, or if you want to see the standalone one-way frequency of a numerical variable, then how one should do it. So there are multiple ways. One way is to use proc format and then create the bins here. For example, I have created a bin low to 159, which means that 159 is the maximum value and the lower values, which has been categorized at less than 160. 160 to 189 has been categorized as 160 to 190. 190 and above has been categorized as greater than 190. One can also do that by using if statement or a case statement or a select statement in a data step, and you can categorize it. But this is like an easy way where you do not need to do any manipulation with the data, and you can use this proc format, and you can create a frequency table, either one-way frequency table or two-way or n-way frequency table between a categorical and numerical variables, and you have to mention this format into the proc freq statement. So this is the code which you can use. So here I have used proc means to see the means of the mean of the data for variable length, and here you can see the mean is 186, and here you can see I have used the proc format and have created the bins for the length variable. And then in table statement I have used origin, which is a categorical variable, and length, which is a numerical variable. And then in the end I have mentioned format for the numerical variable, and here you can see I have created the bins for length, which is mentioned here as LGT. If you want to mention it as ABC, you can mention it as an ABC also. And here you can see LGT, and then a period is there. So this is important thing: format, length, and then what is the format value, which is LGT, which I have mentioned here. You have to mention here as LGT, and then a period. If you want to put it as XYZ, then you have to mention here XYZ and then period. Let's run this code and see the output. So here you can see in this proc freq procedure, where the origin is Asia and less than 160, length of a car is 6. 160 and 90, there are 108 frequency, and Asia and greater than 190 is 44. Whereas in the case of USA, less than 160, length of cars is very low, which is 2, whereas greater than 190 is very high, 96. So this way one can use categorical and numerical variables. And let's say if you have multiple numerical variables, then you can use proc format and create multiple values like LGT, and then you can create a proc freq statement, and then you can use the proc freq procedure, and you can mention numerical variables here, and then you have to mention it in the format statement. So this is an example where we are using categorical and numerical variables and seeing their distribution.
For frequency analysis of more than two variables, use proc freq to create n-way cross tabulation. A series of two-way tables are produced with a table for each level of the other variables. And remember, the order of the variable is important. In n-way tables, the last two variables of the table statement become the two-way rows and columns, whereas variable that precede the last two variables in the tables statement stratify the cross tabulation tables. So here origin and length will become rows and columns, and type will stratify the cross tabulation tables. Let's run the code and see the output.
So here you can see origin and length are the rows and columns, whereas for each type it has created a frequency table. So type equal to hybrid, and you can see the frequency distribution between origin and length. Similarly, for type equal to SUV, you can see the distribution between origin and length of cars, and goes on. And this is the way one can see the n-way frequency table. And I would like to mention here, going beyond three-way frequency table is not very useful. So stick to either two-way or at the most three-way frequency table only.
When three or more variables are specified, the multiple levels of n-way tables can produce considerable output. Such bulky and often complex cross tabulation are often easier to read as a continuous list. Although this eliminates row and column frequencies and percentages, however, the results are compact and clear. And I would like to mention one more thing, that if you are using statistical options such as chi-square or Fisher or odd ratio, the list option is not available. So let's see an example and see how we can use list format to get a compact and clear way of presenting the output.
So here, if you see, the code is exactly the same what we were using earlier for the three-way frequency table. It's just that I have mentioned here as list. Let's run this code and see the output. So you can see here, it is giving us a more concise and you can say a clear output, and this is
a more presentable way if you are sending a report to your manager. So you can see here for hybrid type and origin Asia, length is less than 160, frequency is 1, percentage is 0.23, cumulative frequency is 1, and total cumulative frequency is 0.23, and this goes on till the end. So this is more presentable format. There is something called cross list also. Let's run this code and see the output. So here you can see again the output is similar to the one when we were using the naive three-way frequency table, but it is more compact and clear. So here you can see for type equal to hybrid, Asia is origin, length is 160, frequency is 1, and what is the percentage, row percentage and column percentage. However, the row and column frequencies and percentages have been eliminated. But again, the results are more compact and clear, and this is the way you can send the report to your manager or to the concerned person who wants to do the analysis for various categorical variables. So in this way, you can use list and cross list to get a compact and clear report. Another way to control the format of cross tabulation is to limit the output of Freq procedure to a few specific statistics. Remember that when cross tabulations are run, Proc Freq produces tables with cells that contain cell frequency, cell percentage of total frequency, cell percentage of row frequency, and cell percentage of column frequency. Now, let's say we want to create only a frequency table. In that case, what we can do, we can suppress the table information. And we can do that by mentioning no call, no com, no percent, and no row in the table statement. And here I have put up a forward slash. So what it will do, no percent suppress cell percentages, no row suppresses row percentages, and no call suppresses column percentages. So let's run this code and see the output. Now here you can see this is a very precise report where we are presenting only the frequency distribution between two variables. So in this way, we can suppress the unnecessary statistics and get a desired output. In this case, we want only the frequency distribution between two variables. Let's say if you want to generate multiple crosstab, to accomplish it, one can use this code. So this particular code will generate two crosstab. One will be between origin and length, and the other one will be between origin and drivetrain. So let's run this code and see the output. So you can see here, it has generated the frequency distribution between origin and length and origin and drivetrain. In this way, one can generate multiple crosstab at the same time. Let's say if you want to count number of unique values in a variable, in that case, n levels is going to be a helpful option for you. And we can mention n levels in the Proc Freq statement. Let's run the code and see the output. So here you can see the number of unique values in model variables are 425, and you get a frequency table for that particular variable. In this way, one can use n levels in Proc Freq statement to get the unique values for a particular variable, or if you have a cross tabulation table also, it can give you an output for that. Suppose you wish to save the result in a SAS dataset instead of printing it in result window. One can use out option in table statement and save the result in a data file. No print option prevents SAS to print it in result window. Let's run the code and see the output. So this is a temp file which I have created, and I'm now using the proc print statement to see the output. So you can see this is the frequency table where I'm getting the count as well as the percentage, and this is how you can use this particular SAS dataset again and again. And if you want to save into a permanent library, you can use it there. Or if you want to save as a temporary result, you can use the work library. Another feature of Proc Freq is that it can help us to build a frequency bar chart. To produce a bar chart for a particular variable, we need to add plots equal to Freq plot in table statement. By default, it is going to show you the frequency in the graph. Let's run the code and see the output. So here you can see for a variable origin, it has built a frequency bar chart. Now let's say if you want to show percent in place of frequency, you need to use this particular code. When we are writing plots equal to freq plot, in the brackets, we have mentioned type equal to bar and scale equal to percent, and it is going to show you a percentage in place of frequency for a distribution of a plot. Let's run this code and see the output. So here you can see it has created a bar chart, but in place of a frequency, it is showing you the percentage of a variable origin. In this way, we can build up a frequency bar chart using Proc Freq. If you are working as a data analyst or a data scientist, then definitely you are going to do a missing data analysis. Proc Freq can help us to do the missing data analysis for a categorical variables. By default, Proc Freq does not consider missing values while calculating percentage or cumulative percentage. It will give you the number of the missing values at the end of the table. And the data set which we are working on is a cast data set which does not have any missing values. So what I am doing here, if length is greater than 90, then I am making type equal to missing, so that we can have some missing value in our data set. And I have created a new data set cast2 on the basis of this particular condition. So I'll be using cast2 data set and going to do the analysis for type where we have the missing values. So let's run our code and see the output. So you can see here, it has created a frequency table and mentioning here frequency missing equal to 153. So what we are going to do, if we want to include that this particular missing into our frequency table, then how we are going to do it? So the code is going to remain the same. It's just that we have to include missing into the table statement. When you do that, it will show you type as blank and frequency equal to 153. So in this way, one can do the missing value analysis using Proc Freq for categorical variables. Proc Freq is simple but a very powerful SAS procedure. It can also help us to conduct various statistical analysis between categorical variables such as chi-square test or Fisher exact test or calculating the odd ratios. But since this series is meant for the base SAS programming, and that is why I'm not conducting those statistical analysis. But if you want to do the analysis for categorical variables, go for Proc Freq procedure. Guys, this is the end of session 28. If you like this video, then please do like and subscribe us. Thank you so much. Have a great day.